Torrontés? Ever heard of it? Well, the New York Times has touted it as the hottest thing to arrive from Argentina since the tango. Agronomist Cecilia Echevarra knows what makes Torrontes wine so special. She developed her love for viticulture in Mendoza.
The typical aroma of Torrontes is the Moscatel. But the best Torrontes has a special characteristic that is a floral aroma, like roses. This is a characteristic of a Torrontes. The Torrontes in Cafayate. That's why the wineries in other parts of Argentina are coming to make Torrontes here. And this is because of altitude, because we have fresh nights.
I think Cafayate is a great place to make wines because it's very easy to make organic or at least sustainable agriculture in general. We think that the less you use agrochemicals in general, the more the good things of grapes are kept and expressed in the wine. And this is the easiest place I know to do this, because of wind helps a lot to have healthy grapes. The soil that is very, it has a drainage, very good drainage. Everything is very good to have organic grapes.
The water that we use to irrigate is coming in two ways, always from the mountains. All the rain is concentrated in the mountains, and then this water is coming here or through the surface, like through the rivers. We have here the Colorado River and the Alisal River, that then both together makes the Lorowasi River, that is bringing here the water to irrigate. The water is the most important thing here to make wine. Now is the moment of harvest, and I'm very happy because in fact all our labors and the nature helped us to have good grapes, even if it rained a lot. We have four weeks raining every day, not a lot of water, but very constantly. And the wind here in La Estancia, we have a La Estancia de Cafayate microclimate that helped us to have better Torrontes than in some other places. Because here, as we are quite far away from the mountains where the rain concentrates, we had days without rain here. And the wind dried the bunches quickly. So now we are harvesting, and I think our grapes here in La Estancia are the best in the valley in this moment because of this. We have been waiting since October to have the grapes like they are now. This is the last 2 weeks of March, and we are picking the Torrontes.
Most of us imagine grape picking as sort of a pastoral event, much like they do in Burgundy, France. But I have to warn you, the harvest in Cafayate is just a little more active than you might expect.
Here we are in a typical harvest day in La Estancia de Cafayate. What you can see here is very fast, and it seems like it's a very hard labor, and it is, in fact. We have two goals. My goal is to take the grapes in the best way to the winery to make the best wine, and the goal of the harvesters is to make money. That's why we are like in this hurry. The way we do it is, as you can see, the harvester is taking a box. In this case, it's a 16 kilos box. It's not a 20 kilos box like it's usual, because we try the harvester to carry less weight, but make the harvest in a better way. The foreman is gonna look at the grapes, if they are okay, if there are no bad grapes, if there are no leaves there. They are going to put it inside the truck that is going to take it to the winery, and then it's going to give the harvester as fast as he can the token. This token means that you have harvested one box. So at the end of the day, we can count and know how many boxes a harvester picked. You can see here that to make a good harvest and to get your coin, you have to be really experienced and strong, because this is really fast. You have to know where to cut, not to cut your fingers, and what to cut, because we don't like bad grapes or leaves inside the box.
In the vineyard, you have to have a semi-shaded environment for the Torrontes grapes. That means not too sunny, but also not too shady. At Estancia de Cafayate, they use the trellis system called parral. This is very typical for Cafayate vineyards. During the growing season, the leaves are pruned to get just the perfect mixture of sun and shade. Because of this special care, the grape bunches turn out to be golden color. The best Torrontes wines are made from these kind of grapes. Cecilia and her team have identified places in the vineyard where the Torrontes grapes are more floral than other locations. Grapes from these specially chosen areas are used to make the very best Torrontes.
Now we have a good, nice ripeness. We have very nice aromas in the Torrontes. And what we are looking for usually in Torrontes is to have ripen grapes with the typical Moscato aroma of Torrontes, but at the same time to have floral aromas that are very typical of high quality and elegant Torrontes. This is easy to have here in Cafayate because we have this thermal amplitude between the day and the night, and this helps us to keep all those floral aromas, the rose aromas. This year especially, we are going to have a lot of these because we have had a lot of cloudy days. The wines made with the grapes from here, from La Estancia, are going to be great wines because we have healthy grapes and they have kept all the floral and very delicate and elegant aromas because we have had a lot of cloudy days. So I think the wines this year are going to be fresh, are going to be very elegant, delicate, with the typical Torrontes aroma, but with some other aromas, to flowers, to roses, to white flowers, that some years is not easy to have. So I think it's going to be a great vintage. The Torrontes that is becoming well known is the one from here. We have a lot of wineries from Mendoza that are coming here to buy grapes and to make Torrontes here, and then to sell it with the Cafayate name, you know, because our Torrontes is the one that is becoming famous.
We're eating an apricot.
Hey.
These are very delicious with some dried cheese and Torrontes.
I can't wait to try it.